Good morning, my dear students. So today we have to study GOC, General Organic Chemistry. You know that it's not a general organic chemistry, actually it is a god of organic chemistry. So very, very important to understand very clearly, very easily organic chemistry. So here I want to give some briefing about this topic, general organic chemistry. So just here, no in detail explanation it is. I am explaining in just some words. So general organic chemistry, first of all, that he started with electronic effects. Of course, before that, generally we discuss electrophiles, nucleophiles. That means that's a specific type of reagents. So now here, electronic effects that explain the stability reactivity of the different type of compounds. That means rate of reactions. So here, electronic effects create some imbalance of electron density in a molecule. So based on that imbalance of the electron density, that its reactivity is explained. So among the different type of electronic effects, so one is the inductive effect, resonance or mesomeric effect, and third hyperconjugation. Of course, electromeric effect, inductive effect are there, but these three effects are very, very effective. Now the inductive effect, resonance effect, and hyperconjugation, these are permanent effects. The permanent effects means here, these effects are working in a molecule always. Now here, coming to the inductive effect, this inductive effect is working through the sigma bonds only. Just it is a moment of the sigma bonds towards a more electronegative atom. First, suppose in this case here, fluorine is more electronegative atom. So that electron density attracted towards fluorine. Now here, this fluorine carries a negative charge, this carbon carries a positive charge. Because of this, carbon has a positive nature, again this carbon slightly attract the electron density from the adjacent bond of other side. So as a result here, this one carries some very less minute of the positive charge. That means here the positive charge on this carbon is very less when compared to this carbon. That means here overall the molecule get polarized. So this phenomenon is known as inductive effect. Nothing but moment of the sigma bonding electrons towards more electronegative atom is the inductive effect. So as a result of the inductive effect here, this one carries a negative charge, so it is known as a minus I group. This one carries a positive charge, it is known as a plus I group. Now this minus effect is decreases with increasing distance. Because here this fluorine is directly attached to this carbon, that can create the more positive charge on this carbon. But here this fluorine can create the very less magnitude of the positive charge on this carbon. So that means here this inductive effect is a distance dependent. So here there are some plus I groups and minus I groups. The groups which attract the electron density are the plus I groups. The groups which release the electron density, those are the plus I groups. And the groups which attract the electron density are the minus I groups. So here different type of minus I groups and different types of plus I groups order is given in our class. So next, resonance or mesomeric effect. So resonance is a delocalization of the non-bonding electrons or pi electrons. So for the resonance means, of course here it is a possibility of different type of Lewis structures by change in a position of the pi electrons or position of the non-bonding electrons, but not in the position of the nuclei. There is a change in position of pi electrons, but there is no change in the position of atoms. So it is a delocalization of non-bonding electrons or pi electrons is a resonance. So generally here, the conjugation must be required. The conjugation between what? Among what? Here, conjugation is classified, that means here, there are different type of conjugations. So generally we are saying pi-pi conjugation, or a pi positive charge conjugation, a pi negative charge conjugation. So generally here pi pi conjugation means here two pi bonds are in conjugation. That means here pi bonds are alternatively present. So in this case there is a conjugation, there is a moment of the pi electrons, but in this case there is no moment of pi electrons, there is no resonance possible in this compound. Now here in this case here this oxygen more electronic to that attract the electrons towards itself. So this pi electrons going into the NO2 group, there is a pi pi conjugation. As a result of this pi pi conjugation, this NO2 attract the electrons. Of course it is known as a minus M group or minus R group. So that minus M effect or minus R effect of NO2 increase the positive charge on the ortho position, para position and ortho position. So that minus M group or minus I groups decrease the electron density on the benzene nucleus at ortho, para and ortho. Now here the pi positive charge conjugation. So there is a delocalization of pi electrons like this. Here there is a pi positive charge conjugation. So these two are the resonating structures. So in this case here there is no pi positive charge conjugation. In this case also there is a pi positive charge conjugation. So the conjugation means here there is a proper connection to be happening resonance. So your pi negative charge conjugation. So here pi negative charge conjugation, these two are the resonating structures, this negative charge is delocalized and these pi electrons are delocalized, pi bonds between these two carbons. Now in this case pi bond between these two carbons, that is the delocalization of pi electrons, it's not a localization. Now in this case this negative charge is localized because there is no resonance with this pi bond, so this is localized and this pi electrons also localized, not delocalized. And pi radical conjugation, this pi and single electron are in conjugation. So these two are the resonating structures. These two are the resonating structures. Now here as a result of these resonating structures, here bondlengths are affected. Of course here this double bond. So generally C double bond C bond length is 1.34 angstroms. 1.34 angstroms. And single bond length is 1.54 angstroms. So but here this double bond length is not equal to 1.34 exactly, because here this double bond again becomes a single bond. So bond length is higher than the 1.34, and the single bond length is not exactly equal to 1.54 because this one becomes a double bond. So like this here resonance affect the bond length of the molecule. Now pi lone pair conjugation, this is non-bonding electrons on the oxygen. This non-bonding electron can be delocalized into the pi system. So like this here. So now here first suppose here in the aniline this non-bonding electrons can be delocalized into the pi system, that is the benzene. These electrons are transferred. That means here this group is known as a plus M group or plus R group. The group which has a non-bonding electrons acting as a plus M or plus R group, like NH2 here, NH2 here, OH or NH or NHC double bond O, or this one is a non-bonding electrons, these are acting as a plus N groups, and these plus N groups are acting as donating groups and increase the electron density at ortho and para positions. There is a development of the negative charge at ortho and para positions. So here this NH2 plus, because that lose electrons, this transfer the electrons are transferred to this position, so it carries a negative charge. And this pi electrons transferred to this one. So here like this here at negative charge is developed at para position and ortho position. So the resonating structures of different compounds is clearly given in our class notes, so you can go through that. So next here lone pair and positive charge conjugation. Here positive charge and the group which has a non-bonding electrons is directly attached. So your non-bonding electrons can form a pi bond with this CH2 plus, because here its hybridization is sp2. There is a remaining p orbital, so that is a vacant. So that vacant p orbital can accept the electrons from the oxygen. So it is a pi lone pair positive charge conjugation. So now here, for example, here these two are the resonating structures. Between these two resonating structures, here which is the more stable to be say, like here in this case, this carbon has a six electrons, and now here this carbon has a totally here four, eight electrons, and two here oxygen has a two electrons, here two bonds, that means your four electrons. So here in this one, every atom has octet configuration. Here carbon has no octet configuration. So here this resonating structure is more stable. This resonating structure is less stable because this carbon has no octet configuration. So generally we are saying that the resonating structure which has a octet configuration on every atom is more stable. Now coming to the another one. This one non-bonding, of course here sulfur and this carbon has a negative charge. This negative charge can be delocalized into the vacant orbital of the sulfur. Yes, sulfur is a third period element that has a vacant d orbital, so that can attract the negative charge into the vacant orbital of itself. So here d orbital resonance, so it is a different type of conjugations, that nothing but resonance. Now next, so hyperconjugation. Here hyperconjugation is also known as the Baker-Nathan effect or no bond resonance. So generally it is a delocalization of the sigma bonding electrons into vacant p orbital or pi orbital or off filled p orbital. So generally it is observed in case of the carbocations, free radicals and alkenes. So by the hyperconjugation we can explain the stability of the alkenes. So generally here the number of alpha hydrogens is nothing but number of hyperconjugated structures. For example here this carbocation has a 3 alpha hydrogens, so 3 hyperconjugated structures are possible. First suppose CH3, CH double bond, CH bond, CH3. This one has a 3 alpha hydrogen, this one has a 3 alpha hydrogens, so 6 alpha hydrogen. This alkene has a 6 alpha hydrogens. Or in case of the CH3, CH2, CH2 radical. This one has a 2 alpha hydrogens, so a 2 hyperconjugated structures are possible. So here hyperconjugation generally you are seeing in this carbocation or alkene or radicals. So here based on the hyperconjugation we can explain the mostly stability of the alkenes. The alkene which has a more number of alpha hydrogens more stable. First suppose here CH3, CH2, double bond CH2. This one has a 3 alpha hydrogens, this one has a 6 alpha hydrogens. This is a more stable, this is a less stable. So here more number of hyperconjugated structures, more stable alkene. So generally another application, heat of hydrogenation. The alkene which is less stable that has a more heat of hydrogenation. For example, between these two, this compound has a more heat of hydrogenation because less stable alkene. So here so by this all these electronic effects we can explain the stability of the carbocations, carbanions, free radicals, acidic nature, basicity, and stability of the resonating structures, aromatic nature, and different, there are the different type of applications. Now here generally here stability of carbocations. So carbocations are electron deficient, so these electron deficient carbocations are stabilized by the electron donating groups. Those are the plus psi groups, plus M and plus H groups. And the stability of the carbanions. Carbanions are stabilized by the minus I effect, minus M effect, or minus H effect. Minus H effect means a reverse hyperconjugation that is observed in case of the CCl3 or CF3. And plus H effect means here, for example, methyl. So here, for suppose this benzene attached to the methyl group. This benzene attached to the methyl group. This sigma bonding electron transferred to benzene. So this is a plus H group. For example, this benzene attached to the CCl3. This chlorine is more electronic to that attract the electrons. So that is a minus H group. CCl3 is a minus H group. So now here stability of the free radical. Stability of the free radical is explained on the basis of the hyperconjugation or inductive effect. So more number of alpha hydrogens, more stable radical. So generally acidic nature of alcohols, phenols, carboxylic acids, we know that. So alcohols are acidic nature. Of course in a previous video I explained everything about the alcohols, acidic nature, carboxylic acidic nature, basicity of amines. Now the stability of the resonating structures. So among the different type of resonating structures we can explain the stability. So generally here first we can pick out the stability of different type of resonant structures based on first we have to consider the among all resonating structures, neutral structure is more stable. And then second, we have to consider the resonating structure in which every atom has an octet configuration is more stable. And as a third rule, the negative charge on the more electronegative atom, positive charge on the less electronegative are more stable. So based on those rules, we can identify the stability of different resonating structures. Next here, finally, aromatic nature. The cyclic compounds are classified into three types: aromatic compounds, anti-aromatic compounds, non-aromatic compound. So we know that aromatic compound means here 4N plus 2 pyrochrons, and there is a must, there must be continuous conjugation. For example, here like this here, there is a continuous conjugation total ring. So and this one has a 6 pi electrons that satisfy the 4N plus 2 Hockel's rule. So it is an aromatic compound. Now here this one has a 4 pi electrons, and these electrons are delocalized throughout the ring. So here the continuous conjugation is there, but here 4 pi electrons are there. So it is anti-aromatic in nature. And now for suppose here this compound has a 2 electrons, the negative charge is nothing but 2 electrons. And here 2 electrons, here 2 electrons. So totally this one also has a 6 pi electrons, and there is a continuous conjugation. So it is an aromatic compound. Now here, there is no continuous conjugation throughout the ring. So it is a non-aromatic compound. So cyclic compounds are classified into three types: aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic. So now here, just I want to explain all this with some specific examples. First, suppose here stability of these carbocations. So this one has no alpha hydrogens. This one has a 3 alpha hydrogens. This one stabilized by the resonance. This is stabilized by the hyperconjugation, 3 alpha hydrogens. Now here it is stabilized by the resonance, that means plus M effect. So generally here in this case, by the resonance, this one attains octet configuration CH3O double bond CH2 plus. So in the resonating structure, by the resonance, by the plus M effect, this attains octet configuration. So this carbocation is more stable, and it is stabilized by the resonance, and it is stabilized by the hyperconjugation. So here resonance is more effective to stabilize the intermediates. So this is more stable, and it is stabilized by the also resonance effect, but here there is the octet configuration, so it is a more stable. Next here, no hyperconjugation structures, there are 3 hyperconjugation structures, it is a more stable. So first here, resonance is a more dominating factor than the hyperconjugation. And your hyperconjugation is more dominating than the inductive effect. Now we have stability of the carbanions. For example, here this carbanion has of course no stability when compared to this one, because here there is no stabilizing factor. But here this is stabilized by the minus M effect. That is the resonance, it is stabilized by the resonance. Now here it is stabilized by the resonance, but here this one is stabilized by the aromatic nature, because 6 pi electrons and there is a continuous conjugation. This is aromatic species. Now here 2 electrons, 2 electrons, 4 pi electrons, that is anti-aromatic. Anti-aromatic species are very least stable. So among these four, this aromatic species C more stable, next B, and next A, and D least stable. Even though there is a resonance, because of the anti-aromatic nature, it is a least stable compound. Next here, stability of the resonating structures. So this is a neutral one, this is the ionic species, this ionic species. Neutral one is more stable among the given resonant structures. Now here in this case, on this carbon, there is no octet configuration, but here in this case there is octet configuration, because here this carbon has a 3 bonds and there is a negative charge, nothing but 2 electrons. So there is octet configuration, and around the oxygen 3 bonds, 6 electrons, and 2 non-bonding electrons, so 8 electrons. So in this case here, 2 atoms have octet configuration. This one has no octet configuration. So C is more stable than the B. Now here, in this case, this example, diazomethane. I think we discussed in crossroads also. So in diazomethane, CH2, N plus, N minus. Here N plus means here, the 4 bonds octet configuration. Here 2 bonds, 4 electrons. Here 4 non-bonding electrons, octet configuration. So first of all, it is a more stable, because all have ions, there is no neutral molecule. So first, it is more stable. A is the most stable. And next here, this one has no octet configuration. Now this one has no octet configuration. CH2 minus means here this one has octet configuration. N plus, this one has octet configuration. So next C. Of course here this one also has octet configuration. This one also has octet configuration. But nitrogen has a negative charge. Here carbon has a negative charge. So negative charge on the nitrogen is more stable. That's why first is more stable than the C. And next, between B and D, which is more stable, here carbon has a positive charge, here nitrogen has a positive charge. So more alkyl negative atom cannot bear the positive charge. So it is less stable. That's it. Of course, here there is a different applications of the resonance. For example, a C bond, N bond length. It is one type of previous mains question. So in this case here, carbon nitrogen bond length, how to identify? So in this case here, there is no resonance. There is a complete double bond character. Here there is no resonance, complete single bond character. There is a resonance. Because of the resonance here, this single bond becomes a double bond. So slightly bond length decreases. But a complete double bond, a complete single bond, B higher, next A, and C least. This one by the resonance becomes a double bond nature. Now your carbon oxygen bond length in these compounds. So this is single bond, completely single bond, so D. Now your double bond, double bond, double bond. Here higher the extent of the resonance, higher the extent of the resonance that has a higher single bond character. No resonance, so 100% double bond character. Here no resonance, 100% single bond character, D. Between these two here, this one has a higher extent of resonance, this one has a less extent of resonance. With the higher the extent of resonance here, that double bond becomes a more single bond. So here between these two, here C, and then B, and then A. That's it. So of course here we can explain the acidic nature, basic nature. So generally acidic nature is increased by the minus I groups, minus M groups. In case of the carboxylic acid, every ortho substituted carboxylic acid, irrespective of nature, either plus M or minus M, ortho substituted benzoic acids are more acidic. So that is next year, stability of the free radicals. Here one example, for last example. In this case here, the radical stability is explained on the basis of the hyperconjugation. For suppose here, 2 alpha hydrogens, 2 alpha hydrogens, 3 alpha hydrogens, so totally 7 alpha hydrogens. Now this one, 3 alpha hydrogens, 2 alpha hydrogens, so 5 alpha hydrogens, but there is a resonance, it is stabilized by the resonance. Now here this one has a 1 alpha hydrogen, now this one has a 1 alpha hydrogen, here 2 alpha hydrogen, 3 alpha hydrogens. So it is stabilized by the resonance and as well as the hyperconjugation. So first B more stable. Next here most averaged by the hyperconjugation A, and then D, and least C. That's it. Thank you.